Today's video is targeted more towards agencies and other Voiceflow chatbot builders out there that are starting to take on client work. And really, it's about wrapping our head around the thought process of having a client dashboard and why that is useful. And to me, there's three main reasons why you would want to utilize a dashboard, and specifically a Voiceflow dashboard, to send your clients to. Number one, it gives them access to the transcripts of the AI assistant. And I know for me personally, just from talking to clients, one of the major selling points of these AI assistants is being able to review the transcripts of the chatbot in order to gain additional information from your customers and your users. In some cases, you know, specific targeted outreach campaigns that can be built, improving your customer service just by kind of feeding back, you know, some of those answers back into the chatbots. There are a lot of reasons why you want your clients to be able to view transcripts from your own chatbots. And right now in Voiceflow, as most of you guys know, the only way for you to view your transcripts is through the designer in the transcript tab. So this is my own personal assistant that is sitting on my website right now. I have all of the transcripts here, which is great. But if I build something for a client, they're never going to have access to my Voiceflow account because I have all of my AI assistants up there and all of my other clients. So a dashboard is a great way to kind of keep things organized from you as an agency owner, as well as give the clients an elevated / professional stature here. Excuse my phone. But so that's the first reason. The second reason is the knowledge base aspect of it. And I'm running into this right now with a particular client. And that's because they want the ability to see, upload, add, and delete to the AI assistant's knowledge base on their own, which these dashboards allow you a pretty straightforward, easy way to accomplish this. And instead of, you know, sending emails back and forth, hey, can you add this? Hey, can you add this link? You can just have the client do it themselves. Now, I would caution before you do this to let them know, hey, this is going to change the functionality of this a little bit. And, you know, garbage in, garbage out. You don't just want to dump a bunch of resources that are not super useful into the bot because the quality might suffer. But that's another reason why you would want a dashboard. And then the third and final reason, I already kind of mentioned it before, there's a certain sense of professionalism that comes from having one of these dashboards. And we'll get into one of the chat dash features that I think really helps this out. So as you can see here, it's Voiceflow and OpenAI. So if you have an OpenAI GPT assistant that you've created, you can tie right into it through dashboard as well. But I'm going to be using this primarily through Voiceflow. This is the landing page. One of the other things that ChatDash offers is an analytics page for your chatbot. That way you can see, hey, I've talked to this AI assistant 10 times over the last few days and yada, yada, yada. But we'll see that once we get into this dashboard here. I'm going to go ahead and sign in here. I was looking for the pricing. Here it is. So one of the nice things about ChatDash is that it doesn't cost any money to try it out with the starter version. There's been a few changes through ChatDash. I've been following this product since it came onto the market. This is kind of an updated version. It's much cleaner on the front end, which is great. And the original pricing model was charging people $20 a month after a, you know, relatively short free trial. So I think that it's great that they've shifted their pricing model here to allow people to get in and start on this first starter version for free and make sure that they can fully test out the product before, you know, potentially paying for it down the road. But let's log in here and see what this is, you know, going to look like. So I kind of cleared everything out here just to give us an open slate as we go through and connect some things because I wanted you to be able to see what this is going to look like when you first sign in here. I have already filled out the profile for my agency, which if we scroll down to here, You know, it's got my name and my email address and my password to log into Chat Dash here. I've added my logo of my agency here as my profile picture. And if we come up to agency settings here, we're going to talk about the agency profile. So this is important for you because this is what your clients are going to see when they log into the dashboard here. So here is my agency plan. I'm on the premium right now, and I only have one agency member. It's just me, but you can invite additional team members to look at this and have access to it and edit it, which is a nice touch and a nice feature. I'm going to circle back to this agency white label here in a few minutes. I want to get through the actual nuts and bolts of the product before we touch on the white label feature, which I have set up and is a nice touch. So the two main pages here are projects and clients. So your projects are your specific Voiceflow AI assistants, and then your client management is your specific clients that you're going to have and give access to and whatnot. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to actually start with the project, which if I add the project here, it's going to ask me, is this Voiceflow or is this OpenAI? And it's going to ask for three things, which is the project name, the API key, and the project ID. And I'm going to show you where to get all of these things. The project name is going to be what it's named in Chat Dash. So do not feel that you have to match names with anything in Voiceflow or anything anywhere else. I'm going to actually tie my assistant into this, and I call him Umbri. So that's what I'm going to name it. So for the API and key and the project ID, we're going to go get this from Voiceflow now. So if I swap over to the designer here, if we go to integration, and this is the AI assistant that you want, if you go to project API, your primary API key for this assistant will be right here, which I can click copy and put this over here. And then for the project ID, I come back and in settings, I scroll down the metadata and copy and paste that into here as well. I can also upload a project image here. If I go, where's my logo at? Here we go. And then I click add project. So now Umbri comes up here and I can edit this from right here if I need to edit any of these keys. And there's also a share a test link button here, which basically does the same thing that Voiceflow allows you and puts it into a prototype environment to send out. But I'm not really sure why you wouldn't just use Voiceflow for this instead of this button. But just in case you want to send a test link out to one of your clients, you can do that here. So that's the setting up a project. So the next thing we're going to do is set up a client. So if I add a new client, I'm going to add myself in here. And I will throw out my own email in here. And the password, we're going to do, you know, make a unique one and register me. Okay, so this is a verification link that's going to be sent out, which the person on the other end has to view. So I have to click Chat Dash, verify that email, and then come back in here. Boom, Connor, there's my email. And now there's a button right here that says assign projects. And now I've already created Umbri, so I can just assign Umbri to Connor, the client. Boom, and then you can see this box has come up that shows that these two are linked. So if you click on this features tab, you can toggle off all of the things that you want to show up from the client perspective. So I have analytics, transcripts, and knowledge base toggled on, as well as the base models for whatever this assistant is going to use. So this is basically reskinning what the Voiceflow designer allows you to do from a customization standpoint, because this is exactly what the knowledge base settings tab in the designer looks like as well. So if I save those changes, if I click preview, this is what it's going to look like from the client side. Okay, so in the last 7 days, 37 people have talked to my assistant. yada, yada. I can see the interactions, the users, the sessions. Top intents is a nice feature. So you can see that, you know, people are clicking schedule a call. But the meat and potatoes here that we mentioned before is the transcript. And I can now see the same exact transcript from all of my users over the past few days where people have been booking calls with me. So from the client's perspective, pretending I'm the client here, this is valuable because I can access this transcript and go through and read the various interactions that the AI assistant has had. Knowledge base. I do not have anything linked to the knowledge base for my own assistant. And I'm actually not even using Voiceflow's knowledge base. I'm using Voiceflow as a router to tap in through an OpenAI assistant for this particular use case. But you can add data sources in here just like the Voiceflow knowledge base with the URL and the sitemap or a PDF. And the same thing with the preview button and the system prompt can be done here through the client side. So this is what it would look like if I logged in from the client side. So that's kind of a basic overview of where we what you would see from the client side when using ChatDash. And I'm moving over here to show this exit preview. And now I'm back in my agency admin portion of this. You can assign multiple projects to each client, which is a nice feature, especially if you have continuing work and multiple agents that you're setting up for each individual client. So it kind of cycles through the dashboard for them, which is definitely a nice touch. And the only other thing that I kind of want to go through quickly is the agency white label opportunity here, which means that you can actually have a custom domain for your agency dashboard, which I think is a nice touch because that way you don't have to send clients to ChatDash, okay? And for me personally, I have this set up, which is, you know, a dashboard.umbral.ai. So when I can send my clients directly to a URL that's branded, and this is what it looks like, which is, yes, it's a ChatDash login, but really this looks like an Umbral login, which is a nice touch and I think adds a little bit of legitimacy, you know, to whoever is going to, you know, log in here. And I can log in with what I set up for my client and pretending I'm the client. Here we go. So here's me agreeing to ChatDash terms. And now I am a client logged in to my branded URL here. And I can look through the knowledge base and the transcript and the change password if I need to. And if I have multiple projects, I can do the drop down here and cycle through various things. So anyways, this is really a relatively quick overview, but I wanted to make a quick video on this because I have clients specifically asking, hey, we want to be able to add, you know, into this knowledge base on our own for these AI assistants, or I want to be able to look at these transcripts from, you know, one place without, you know, using your own agency login to Voiceflow and whatnot. So these dashboards and user functions for Voiceflow are going to continue to be created by the community, which is great because Voiceflow wants to keep a very narrow, tight-banded focus on making sure they are the most in-depth, best agent builders on the market. So I know that there are a lot of these community solutions popping up here. And really my only advice, especially for, you know, free usage for the beginning, get in here and try it out and see which UIs that you like, see what functionalities you like. I like the white label aspect of ChatDash here, the improvements that they've done on the UI recently. But you have to keep in mind, you know, a lot of this stuff is, you know, work in progress as they work through various things. So take that all with a grain of salt. And if it's a solution that, you know, you think might be valuable, check it out. Anyways, that's all I've got today. Feel free to drop any comments below. I'll talk to you guys later.